know, Dan, it is a chance. It's always been a challenging schedule, and we knew this up front. But our players watch the Baylor tape, and there's a lot of things we can work on and get better at. And I think what we did the second half was assuring for us. I mean, it was a good something to lay our hat on. First half was not very good for us, but I think once we settled down and understood that these guys said that they felt like the second half they could compete, and I think that's what they're building the practice on today and where we're going. So I think they're excited to play Stanford, and they're excited to play at home. So. Yeah, I don't know if we're going to have her, but I think the chances of having her on Saturday are a lot better than obviously for Baylor. Baylor was a long shot, but I'm very, very optimistic that we'll have her.
When you look at the tape from Baylor, were you able to identify a reason for that slow start? What are you going to, what are you working on?
Well, we let our offense affect our defense, and as we shot the ball poorly, our defense was non-existent, and we didn't rebound the basketball. And this program is built on defensive rebounding, and we did not do those things that have gotten us where we are right now.
Safe to say that'll be an emphasis in practice.
That is a huge emphasis today in practice. It's just, you're going to have off nights, and what brings you back is your ability and your heart and your desire, your willingness to play defense, and the discipline to do what you need to do on the defensive end and boxing.
Go to me.
This is a young team, and you've played a lot of ranked teams up to now, but you're basically in top five teams. What do you think some of the underclassmen learned about themselves, learned about what needs to be done?
I think they need to trust our system, and we need to make sure that defense and rebound are a priority. It was a tough environment. It was against a great basketball team. We're not there yet. We're going to get there. And I think that we can use Baylor as an example right now of playing together and playing on both ends of the floor.
What's the next step in terms of progress?
I just don't think we take defense as a priority. We've got to get better on the ball, all aspects of our defense. We've got to get better on the ball, post defense, finishing the defense with boxing out. I thought those things we were very weak. You know, when you give a player on the opposing team 16 rebounds, you're not playing the way we want you to play. So we've got to make sure that. We get back more aggressive on the ball, more aggressive on the defensive end. And I thought we didn't communicate. There's no communication on defense because we were worried about what just happened on the offensive end. So our communication was poor. And defense is a team effort. And it involves hard work, but communication as well. We didn't do that in the Baylor game.
Sorry. Talk about Stanford and the challenges they bring.
Well, I think Stanford has a kid inside, Shanae Gumke, that's she's outstanding. She's All-American, and she's going to be a difficult defend for us. I think they're well coached, disciplined in everything they do. So they're going to they spread the floor. They're just, all of them can shoot. They can penetrate. So it's just a difficult team for us to defend.
What would it mean for you as a coach and the players to knock off number one here tonight?
It'd be awesome. I love it. It's just a chance for us to get a better taste in our mouth from Baylor, and to compete and to play at a level that we need to play in front of our fans would be tremendous.
Well, you turn them loose after the game too for Christmas. How do you keep them focused that some of them aren't already thinking about going home before tip-off Saturday?
You know, Marie, I'm not worried about them thinking about Christmas. I think what happened to us at Baylor and our opponent coming up, I don't see us. I have not noticed anybody thinking, well, let's hurry up and get this game over and let's go home. This team is very focused. They scouted. They evaluated themselves for the Baylor game. They said what we did good, what we did wrong, how we need to improve. They did all the post-game reporting. And we just talked about that today. So I think they understand. And then they're going to scout Stanford as well and get prepared for that.
You sometimes do that when they're out of school. That's a good exercise.
Absolutely.
For them.
Absolutely. So they can formulate their ideas. We may not use them. They get the opportunity to watch a tape, figure out what we're going to do, how we're going to guard certain people, and I think it's a great exercise for them and a great building tool for us.
Well, given the youth of this team, would they be better served by maybe playing a lesser team after or do you like the fact that you go right back on the
You know, Dan, the schedule is what it is, and we can't dodge it. And to get back on the horse and to play the number one team in the country is what we've done. So I would prefer not playing Texas a day off, Baylor, and then took a couple of days off in Stanford. That's just brutal. It's just brutal, to be very honest with you. But it is what it is, and we just take one game at a time. And thought it was very important we got the Texas win. And then to get focused for Baylor and then to come in here and get some rest, but also prepare for Stanford's huge for us.
Stanford, just freshmen. Did you see a lot of determination out of them at Baylor? I mean, I know they were overmatched, but they hung in there, didn't they?
I love Nia's effort. She had no fear, didn't know what she needed to be afraid of. And she competed. She's one of the few that competed, I thought, the first half. And was pleased with her, and she played 16 minutes, and I thought she got quality minutes for her, and I think she'll help us against
Stanford. Do you want to get her more minutes?
Absolutely.
I mean, do you feel like you have to? And you've seen now what happens to your post game when you lose a player. I mean, do you feel like you need to get her?
Well, I think it's twofold. I feel like I have to, and I want to, because she's one of our best practice players, and I think she just needs experience on the floor. And so every time I've seen her there, and she gets better and better. So I think the more reps she gets, the more practice, the more game-like situations for her.
Is Phillips still a coach's decision?
Phillips is a coach's decision, yes. And she's not all the way healthy right now either. So
Does that factor into your thinking?
Yes.
Stanford had a bit of a close call last night. I mean, does that give you any confidence? Maybe, or does it make them seem that much tougher? They had a battle, were able to survive.
Well, I think I think South Carolina had a lot to do with what Stanford struggled with, their defense, and I think it's reassuring to our players to see that yes, if we get out and play, we can affect Stanford. I mean, South Carolina did a heck of a job; they just couldn't make shots. I think you watch that game and you do see. Results of your defensive rebounding and how it can affect any team. So, and then it's any given night, whether you're one or 20 or whatever you're ranked. As we know, any given night you can get beat or you can pull one out.